everyone, assalamu alaikum. In this video, we will discuss the maxilla, which is also known as the upper jaw. Do you know that maxilla is the second largest bone on the face? Yes, it is. The largest bone is the mandible and the maxilla is the second largest. Remember that. Now, when we talk about maxilla, its body is the largest part of it. The body of maxilla is somewhat pyramidal in shape and contains a large cavity that is called the maxillary sinus. It has four surfaces: anterior, posterior, superior, and medial surface. Starting with the anterior surface, it directs forward and laterally, and it presents the incisive fossa, which gives origin to the depressor septi. Below the incisive fossa, the incivus arises, and superolateral to this fossa, the nasalis muscle arises. This is the canine eminence and this is the canine fossa here, which gives origin to levator anguli oris. Above the canine fossa, this is the infraorbital foramen, which carries infraorbital nerves and vessels. Between the infraorbital margin and foramen, the levator labii superioris arises. This is the nasal notch right here, and the anterior surface bordering the nasal notch gives origin to the nasalis and depressor septi. Next is the posterior surface or the infratemporal surface, which is concave and directed backward and laterally. It forms the anterior wall of the infratemporal fossa. Posterior inferiorly, maxillary tuberosity can be seen. It is a rounded eminence and gives origin to the superficial head of the medial pterygoid laterally. Above this maxillary tuberosity, the surface forms the anterior wall of the infratemporal fossa, grooved by the maxillary nerve. The third one is the superior surface or the orbital surface, which is smooth, triangular, and is slightly concave. It forms a greater part of the floor of the orbit. Its anterior border forms part of the inferior orbital margin. Its posterior border forms most of the anterior margin of the inferior orbital fissure, and its medial border presents a lacrimal notch. Anteriorly, behind the notch, it articulates with the lacrimal, labyrinth of the ethmoid, and orbital process of the palatine bone. On the orbital surface, we find a groove, a canal, and a foramen. The infraorbital groove leads into the infraorbital canal, which opens here on the surface as the infraorbital foramen. Now, this is the passage of the infraorbital nerves and vessels. Note that in the midpoint of this canal, there is a lateral branch called the canalis sinuus for the transmission of anterior superior alveolar nerves and vessels. Last is the medial or the nasal surface, which is a part of the lateral wall of the nose. Posterior superiorly, it displays the maxillary hiatus. Above the hiatus, air sinuses are present. Below the hiatus, part of the inferior meatus is present. Behind the hiatus, the surface articulates with the perpendicular plate of palatine bone and encloses greater and lesser palatine canals. In front of the hiatus, nasolacrimal groove is present. Moving more anteriorly, an oblique line forms conchal crest, and above this crest, a shallow depression is seen, which forms the part of the atrium of the middle meatus of nose. Moving to the four processes of maxilla. We have frontal process, zygomatic process, palatine process, and alveolar process. The alveolar process forms the maxillary dental arch containing eight cavities where the upper teeth are held. The frontal process has a vertical ridge which constitutes the medial border of the orbit. The zygomatic process of the maxilla grows laterally and meets the zygomatic bone. Lastly, the palatine process is a horizontal extension on the medial side of the bone, constituting the roof of the mouth and the floor of the nasal cavity. Talking about articulations in maxilla, the maxilla articulates with numerous bones, superiorly with the frontal bone, posteriorly with the sphenoid bone, palatine, lacrimal bone, and ethmoid bone, medially with the nasal bone, vomer, and inferior nasal concha, and laterally with the zygomatic bone. Let's talk about ossification. The maxilla develops from three centers, one for the maxilla proper and two for a smaller bone called os incisivum. The ossification of these centers begins during intrauterine life at specific times. One premaxillary center appears above the incisive fossa while another forms near the nasal septum before fusing with the palatal processes of the maxilla. Although it starts to fuse early on, evidence may remain that the premaxilla is a separate bone until later in life. The development of maxilla and mandible shall be discussed in detail in the embryology section. Let's talk about eight changes. At birth, transverse and antero-posterior diameters are larger than the vertical diameter. The frontal process is well defined. The body is slightly larger than the alveolar process, with the tooth sockets reaching the floor of the orbit. The maxillary sinus is a small furrow on the lateral wall of the nose. In adulthood, the vertical diameter becomes the greatest due to the development of the alveolar process and an increase in the sinus size. In old age, the bone reverts to an infantile condition with reduced height resulting from alveolar process absorption. Now let's summarize. The maxilla, also known as the upper jaw, consists of four projections that include frontal process, zygomatic process, palatine process, and alveolar process. It has four surfaces: anterior, posterior, superior, and medial. Each maxilla ossifies from two main combined centers, one for the maxilla proper and one for the premaxilla. These fuse early in the human development, about the 9th week in utero, and each maxilla articulates with 9 bones: frontal, ethmoid, nasal, zygomatic, lacrimal, palatine bone, vomer, inferior nasal concha, as well as the maxilla of the other side. Some important questions from this topic include: what are the ossification centers of the maxilla? Name the four projections of maxilla. Mention the muscle attachments on the lateral surface of maxilla. What bones make up the maxilla? Until we meet next time, keep revising. I'll see you in the next video. Allah Hafiz.